everybody, welcome back to Clever TV. I'm Jocelyn Davis with Dana Ward.
Hey guys.
And today we are so excited to be joined by our friend and gaming expert, Haley from Clever Games.
Thank you.
Hello.
I'm excited to be here. It's awesome.
So it was a really big week. E3 is going down. You were just there and you're going to kind of fill us in on what you saw.
Yeah, right? It was awesome. Okay, so first of all, I started out the day, went to Power A, which they make a lot of game controllers and things for different products. So this was probably one of the coolest things I saw. This is called a Moga Pro controller, and it helps you game with your phone.
That's
really cool.
So no longer do you have to have the thumbs that are hurting from using your iPhone. You can switch it to a different sort of hold.
And the ones that are out right now only work with Android phones, but they're actually coming out with one that they showed us at E3 that uses your iPhone.
That is so
cool. It's very cool. And what's really cool is the new ones are going to have you can play multiplayer, so you can play up to 4 players, and then you can actually use a Surface tablet, hook that into your TV with an HDMI cable, and then you don't need a console anymore.
That's crazy.
You don't need a console anymore. It's
cool. So everybody has one of these controllers, and they're all set to play.
Yeah, you can just sit there with your friends and like play on your TV.
This is mind-blowing.
Can you play any game that you have an app for?
You can play any game you have an app for.
What? My mind is blown.
It's kind of neat because a lot of games you can buy for, you know, $4. So it's like, that's great.
Do you know how much something like that costs approximately?
They told me that this one was about $50. So it's really not that much.
And games cost more than that.
Yeah, games cost about
$70. Very affordable. Very affordable. Cool. What else did you see?
And then at that same booth, they make a line of phone cases. So they just came out with a Star Trek line.
Oh, that's awesome.
I know, right? And they also do a Star Wars line that's currently on the market. So I was like, oh, that's fun. J.J. Abrams.
Really cool.
And then they do some for Skylanders as well.
Okay.
And then this is called a Battle Arena. This is currently on the market. And you can take your Skylanders figures and put them all around this and then put your portal in the middle and they can just get ready for battle, basically.
Oh,
ready
my
to go.
Gosh.
But some of the new stuff that they have that's not on the market yet, Skylanders Swap Force is the new Skylanders game.
Mm-hmm.
And they have all these carrying cases and display cases. So you can actually open up a case and it displays each character individually, like a show-off case. Like, here's my 50 best characters. Let me just lay them out for you.
Wow. And you can take them with you, like, to your friend's house or whatever. Like,
totally.
And that's very intimidating.
I know, right?
Look what I have.
Because the Skylanders characters actually come, you know, some are really expensive, some are hard to find. So it's definitely like back in the day when we had
Beanie
like
Babies. Collector items.
Yeah, some are.
Oh, that's so cool.
Pretty neat, right?
Okay, so as far as the actual games go, what did you try out and what did you love?
Probably my favorite new game was this game called, from Microsoft, called Project Spark.
Mm-hmm.
And it's cool because it's actually a game that helps you create your own game.
It's a game within a game.
Yeah, it's a game within
a game.
But I felt like something that really spanned this year's E3 over all the games was they wanted to give power to the players. Power for you to create, power for you to control. It's all about you now, which is really
cool.
But
that gives you a lot of creativity, too, which makes it just more interesting, more intriguing over a long time period.
In this particular game, you can start with a blank slate, and you can build a world from there, or you could go in and say, like, I wanted to play your game.
Mm-hmm.
I could play your game, and then I could start creating on your game.
Ooh.
I know, right?
Whoa. Oh, that's so
interesting. But everyone has to sign off, right? Like, I have to say, oh, I want you to create on my game.
You can play other people's games, and I think that you can create on top of that, but you are licensing, like you're putting it online and saying, okay, community, here's my game. Play it, check it
out. You have to let people do it.
You have to let people do it.
So I got some pretty cool games are going to come out of Project Spark.
Yeah, and apparently I was asking them yesterday, like, what's the coolest thing you've seen so far? And they said, oh, someone made a keyboard. Which it sounds simple, but like programming a keyboard in a game.
That doesn't sound simple to me.
That's really cool. Literally
has,
no idea.
Does all the music. They said you could even like remix music from or like remix things from the keyboard. I was like, that's really
that's
cool.
Art
so
right
basically
there.
All you need for entertainment is Project Spark.
Yeah.
Seems like.
Yeah, you can make
But there was
game.
Other cool stuff at E3.
Yeah, we saw a lot of stuff at the Nintendo booth.
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys fans of Nintendo and
Who
Mario?
Isn't?
I mean,
I think you grew up on it, right?
It's illegal not to be.
They had Super Mario 3D World.
Oh my gosh.
It's all in 3D, and you can play it on your Wii U. And the coolest thing was that they have a cat suit now. So in the last game, we had a raccoon suit. Now you have a cat suit.
Ooh.
So if you want to play as, like, Princess Peach, you can put it, like, go get the cat suit, and then I can claw you, scratch you, tumble past you.
Awesome.
I wonder if they're inspired by that grumpy cat that's so trendy.
Oh, yeah, maybe so.
Cats are very in right now.
I wonder what will be next.
I don't know, dog suit. No, that would be lame.
I hope a unicorn or something.
Oh, that would be cool. Yeah. That's totally what it's going to be.
I know, that would be really cool.
But 3D, that's insane.
I know, it was really neat. And then we saw Donkey Kong Country, Tropical Paradise.
I used to love that game.
Yeah? This one's cool. You can barrel and hit fish and swim through things. And then you play with the Wii remotes. Uh-huh. So when Donkey Kong does this, and he's like, wah.
You're doing it too.
You're doing that, and that makes him do it.
Oh.
So everything was like really interactive. When you make them barrel towards things, you're actually turning the Wii remote to make them do that or like moving it.
Well, you're getting a workout too, which is
great. You're getting a little
workout. You don't even realize it, but you probably are.
Yeah, it was neat. All the characters were cool. And it had a lot of bright colors in it. I felt like it was a visually interesting game as well. And also at the Nintendo booth, I played Mario Kart 8.
Whoa.
How is there an 8th
I thought it was
version?
Like 20.
Crazy.
Here's the funniest thing. The longest line at the Nintendo booth was for Mario Kart. I literally waited 20 minutes to play
what?
The game.
So how did it
was
go?
It
what did
it?
You think?
Yeah. No, it was totally worth it. I came in first place.
High five.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was cool. They have, at one point, you can actually hit something and get a power, so you have, like, this hand glider, and then you can glide over all the other cars and be like, haha,
peace
suckers.
Out, yo. I love it.
All right.
So lots of cool power-ups, and, you know, they have the usual, like, the ramps, and, you know, you can hit and get mushrooms or fireballs. Same things from, like, the previous Mario Kart games.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
And Jocelyn and I are really big fans of any of the dance games out there.
Oh, yes. Any new dance games?
Yeah, is there anything we can look out for?
We
do.
Like the Ubisoft games, right?
We dominate.
Yeah, so we saw Fantasia Music Evolved, which is kind of a more creative version of Just Dance, where you can change the music in the game depending on how you move. So you have multiple paths you can take. You're like, do I want to take the pink path, the yellow path, or the blue path? And if you move your arm this way creatively, it will pick one of the paths. And the music changes with the path. So you could do
We're already doing it. We don't even have the game.
It changes from like country music to more whimsical music. I'm not sure. I didn't get to rap music, but I would assume it can go that way.
Yeah.
It can go any way you want.
If you do some twerking, maybe.
Yeah.
You got some Miley Cyrus twerking.
It definitely seemed very creative. And I wasn't a very good dancer, but you guys should play it because you might be. It's all about being super creative. And I was just doing this the whole time. So,
well, there's definitely something for everyone, and that's what you find out at E3. What would you say overall you're most excited about from the entire convention?
I really liked Project Spark the most.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But outside of games that I got to see, because we were seeing definitely a certain segment of games, probably Ubisoft has a new game called Watch Dogs.
Okay.
And that looks amazing. It's you're in a game, and it's about you being this tech expert and about using all this tech to move through a city and rewire and do things so you can get around.
Mysterious.
It's very
like
mysterious
that.
And it's very cool.
Ooh, cool.
But there are a lot of great games coming out this year. I would say it was probably one of the best E3s we've had in a long time.
That's exciting.
With just the amount of really good games being shown off, you know?
Very, very cool.
So it seems like there is a lot
that
we need to check out that happened at
E3. Definitely. There's so many things.
Well, I'm going to go head over to Clever Games, check you out there, Haley.
Thank you.
And make sure you guys check out Haley at Clever Games also. We have a link below if you want to see what was going down at E3. Keep it here at Clever TV for all of your entertainment news and more. I'm Dana Ward with Jocelyn Davis and Haley Bright. We'll see you guys next time.